Oh, hi, you're here. Good. Molly and I were just about to play a game of pickup sticks. Come on, Molly, this'll be fun. Now, here's how you play. First, you drop the sticks every which way. And then you try to pick them up one stick at a time without moving any of the other sticks. Okay, now I'm gonna try to pick up this blue one, I think. Now, come on. Oh, this is tougher than I thought. Ooh, this must be a tricky stick. Hey, tricky stick. That's a funny name. Or maybe it's a stuck stick. Come on, you tricky stuck stick. Oh, there we go. Hey, I must be a super stick picker-upper. Mm-hmm. Hey, Molly, that's my new nickname. Okay, your turn, Molly. Oh, Molly, your nickname must be Clumsy Clown. Clumsy Clown. Well, that's okay, Molly. Don't worry, we can pick it up after the game. Here, I guess it's my turn now, isn't it? Now watch carefully, Molly. Molly? Oh, that's right. You didn't pick up any. Oh, well, maybe you'll do better next time. Want to play another game? Oh, that's right. You'll probably be a clumsy clown next time, too. Well, I'll just put these sticks away until you're ready to play again. Wait a minute. There's only 5 sticks here. One's missing. Where could it be? Don't be ridiculous, Molly. Every clown knows that dust bunnies do not exist. So how could they have my missing pickup stick? Now, where could it be? Oh, I'll get it. Ooh, you know, I'm feeling kind of stiff from sitting for so long. Maybe I'll feel better after I do my clock stretch. Yeah. Oh, here, Molly. You should practice, my clumsy clown.
Maybe this will work.
Thank you.
after my stretch. In fact, I have so much energy, I think my nickname should be Lively Lunette. And now Lively Lunette is ready to go outside. And how about you, Molly Polly Dolly? Do you want to come with me?
Uh-oh.
Look, Molly, you've dropped the pickup sticks all over the floor. I guess Clumsy Clown is definitely a better nickname for you. Okay, let's go outside, Molly. Come on. Well, what's wrong? Don't you want to go outside anymore? Oh, I guess you just changed your mind. Sometimes dolls change their minds. Well, I guess you don't have to come outside with me if you don't want to. In that case, I'll go myself. And maybe when I get back, we can play pick-up sticks again. Okay, well, you wait right here, and I'll be right back. My favorite little clumsy clown. Okay, let's go outside. Hello there. I know. Let's give everything a nickname. Now, this gate, it could be a great garden opener. And, oh, that tree isn't a tree. It's a super sky scratcher. And, oh, that's not a horn. It's Major Bedhead.
Hey, hiya, Lunette. What you doing?
Well, I'm thinking up nicknames for everything in the garden.
Oh, that sounds like fun. I love silly nicknames. What do we call, this? Boy, this flower really did something to my nose. I think it's, Nosy Rosy.
Oh, that's good. Let's see, something else. Here. What could this be? Try it on. I know, it's a bedhead redhead holder. Hey, what about my shoe? What could that be?
Puddin' it.
That's a great nickname. What about Snickle Fritz?
A four-footed fuzzy face.
Perfect. Four-footed fuzzy face.
Well, so long, my favorite fuzzy wuzzy face. I gotta go, Lunette. I got lots more deliveries to do.
Oh, goody. Do you have a PG postal picture for me?
No, but I do have a postcard from your Auntie Macassar.
Exactly. That's what I meant. Thank you. Oh, look. It's a picture of Auntie Macassar way high up in the sky in a plane. That looks like fun. Let's see what she says.
Dear Lunette, I'll have to keep this short because I'm right in the middle of a parachute lesson. Right now, we're cruising at about 25,000 feet, and I just wanted to drop you a quick note because I have to be going.
That's funny. She doesn't really finish the letter. She just says, I have to be going. But she doesn't say where she's going to.
Do you hear something?
Yes, I do. But it sounds like... Auntie Macassar.
Major Clumsy? I beg your pardon, Lunette, but I am not Major Clumsy. You can call me almost anything you want, but Major Clumsy is not one of those things.
Well, wait a second. I think I'm the one who should be called Clumsy. Wasn't the world's greatest landing.
Major Clumsy. Some clowns don't like to be called Clumsy. Some clowns like me.
Major Bedhead, Major Clumsy was just a nickname. I didn't mean to hurt your feelings.
Oh, you did.
Well, I'm sorry. I take it back.
Thanks.
Now, not all nicknames are bad. Well, when I was growing up, my antihistamine used to call me Macaroni. I really like that nickname.
Macaroni? I like that too.
Right, so did I. It sounded like Macassar, and it was my favorite food. I like that nickname just fine, but...
But what?
Other aunt, Auntie Pasto. She used to call me Macadamia Nut because she said I was so nutty all the time. I didn't like that nickname at all.
Well, why not? I mean, it can't hurt. Nicknames are just for fun.
Mm-hmm. You can say I'm stinky as long as you're joking around. Give me the thumbs down. You can't even say I'm ugly as a rolling stone. Oh, things you say don't bug me. They don't rattle my bones, no. Sticks and stones might break my bones. Names you call won't hurt at all. Ones that stick might make me thick if they're kind, and I don't mind. No, down, now, down. Don't throw them sticks and stones. Nicknames can be funny, can even make me feel good. But if you're trying to hurt me, do you think you really should? Sticks and stones might break my bones. Names you call won't hurt at all. Ones that stick might make me thick if they're kind, then I don't mind. Now down, now down. Don't throw them sticks and stones. Don't throw them sticks and stones. Don't throw them sticks and stones.
Thanks, Annie Macassar. Well, I guess I never really thought that much about nicknames before.
Me neither.
Oh. Meow. Thanks. Sorry for calling you clumsy, Major Bedhead.
Oh, that's all right. It was only a nickname. Hey, but I better get going, or someone else might call me another nickname, like Major Much Too Late. I have a special delivery across town.
Well, you can hitch a ride with me.
I can?
Sure, just grab on and we'll take this parachute and fly across to your next job. It'll be airmail.
Hey, come I'll on. Just go get my pogo stick.
Okay, now, we're all gonna have to blow really hard to get this thing off the ground. You ready? One, two, three. And away we go!
Keep blowing, Lunette!
Goodbye, you clowns in the clouds! Goodbye, my fine flying friends! See you soon! Whew. There they go!
Here comes Granny!
Boy, I sure am glad Auntie Macassar told us all that stuff about nicknames. I never realized nicknames could hurt a clown's feelings. I just thought they were fun. Wait a minute. You don't think I hurt Molly's feelings when I called her a clumsy clown? Maybe that's the reason she didn't want to come outside and play. I didn't mean to hurt Molly's feelings, but I guess I did. Well, I'm going to hurry back to the couch right away and tell her I'm sorry. Molly, I'm back, and I missed you. But maybe you didn't miss me if I did something to hurt your feelings. Did I hurt your feelings, Molly? It was when I called you clumsy clown, wasn't it? I'm sorry, Molly. I was just having fun with silly nicknames, and sometimes nicknames can hurt. I didn't mean that you're really clumsy. No, you're not clumsy. Just... more like awkward or dropsy or uncoordinated, but not clumsy. Uh-oh. I've done it again. I'm not saying the right things, am I? Molly, do you want to be alone right now? To do something to cheer Molly up. But what can I do? I know. I'll make up a special ballet dance, all for her, and then I'll take her to the dance academy. That'll cheer her up. Now, I need to find just the right costume. Oh, I didn't see that. I wasn't watching where I was going. Guess that was kind of clumsy of me, actually. Oh! Isn't this a pretty scarf? Oops, that was really clumsy of me. Oh, what a pretty dress. Ah. Hello, who turned out the lights? Oh, excuse me, sorry. Wait, There. I'm a ballerina. I look really silly, don't I? Like a clumsy ballerina. Molly will love it. Molly. Ta-da! Do you like me as a ballerina, Molly? A clumsy ballerina? You do? Goody. Want to come with me? Great. Let's go for the show.
Loonies and jelly beans, boys and gurgles, please welcome to Miss Lunette's Dance Academy that dancing fool, the one and only clumsy ballerina herself, Lunette the Clown.
Was fun, but being clumsy all the time really wears me out. I think it's time for a story. What do you think, Molly? Now, where is that storybook? Here it is. And my glasses. Oops, almost forgot. Can't read without good light, can you, Molly? Today's story is called The Bird Without a Name. Once upon a time, there was a bird who didn't know her own name. So she asked all her friends what her name might be. Her friend Shining Sun said her name must be Big Beak. After all, he said, your beak is very large. It's the perfect name for you. But the bird didn't think that it was the right name at all. Surely something about her must be more important than her big beak. There must be a better name for her somewhere. So off she flew. Her friend Rainy Cloud watched her fly this way and that, flipping and flopping around in the sky. You're not very good at flying, said Rainy Cloud. I think your name must be Floppy Flyer. But the bird didn't think that that was a very good name, so she flew down to the ground where she could ask someone else. Next, she met her friend Smelly Skunk. He noticed the bird's unusual feathers. They were all kinds of crazy colors, sticking out this way and that. Your name must be Funny Feathers, laughed the skunk. But the bird didn't think that name was funny at all. By now, the bird was feeling very sad. I'm tired of everyone giving me funny names, she said. I want a real name, a pretty name, One that's really mean. Just then, the bird looked down into the river and saw a strange reflection. There was a strange-looking bird with a very large beak and crazy-colored feathers and large and floppy wings. The bird started to laugh. "Look at that funny bird," she said. Then suddenly, the bird with no name realized something very funny. "That funny-looking bird is me!" And then the bird started laughing and laughing. She just couldn't stop. She laughed so long and so loud, her laughter rose up in the sky and all around the valley, and her laughter could be heard by all of her friends. "What is that lovely laughter?" asked Shining Sun. "Those are such glorious giggles," said Rainy Cloud. "I love the sound of the laughing bird," said Smelly Skunk. And so the bird rose up into the air and laughed everywhere she went. Everyone wanted to hear her beautiful song. And from then on, everyone knew the name of the laughing bird. The end. Boy, that was a really good story, wasn't it, Molly? You know that old saying, "Sticks and stones can break my bones, but names can never hurt me"? Well, I think sometimes the wrong names can hurt birds and clowns and dolls. Right, Molly? Oh. Well, I better put these things Ow! What was that? A stick? And a stone? You know, these things really do hurt. Oh, boy. Hey, look at all this stuff. Who made this big mess? Me? Oh, I did, didn't I? Well then, I have to clean it up. It's only fair. So get ready for the 10-second tidy. Ready, set, go! Well, it's been a busy day, hasn't it, Molly?
Shh, she's asleep. And now you're a little sleepy clown, or maybe a cuddly dolly, or a snuggly Molly. Come to think of it, I'm kind of sleepy myself. Just call me Lullaby Lunette. Well, thanks a lot for coming today. See you real soon.
And the clown jumped over the moon.